speed. I've got your attention now, right? Let's get more clubhead speed, right? Speed creation. And to talk about creating speed or recruitment, that's a word I use a lot, we need to talk about the backswing. I work on the backswing a lot with students, in particularly these next two videos. Okay, we're gonna talk about the lower body first in this video, and then the next one we're gonna talk about the upper body in the spine, and then we'll give it like some general checkpoints that'll really complete your backswing. But what I would recommend is as you get to video three down, you start working on this lower body. This is gonna help so many of you. It's interesting, as you go through these training programs, if you just did the first one, it's gonna help you. The setup helps so many. The second one, the general swing shape can help so many. And then it's like, okay, I go to the third one, and now I'm starting to recruit better my lower body, and all of a sudden, wow, I'm really hitting it better. So you can kind of bite off as much as you want. Now, I've got this stick in the ground, and I'm gonna put it on an angle here, alignment stick. This is just a stick that I got from a set that I bought that actually represents a plane angle. So anything will work here. You can put a chair here, anything. So I put it in the ground right next to my trail leg, right? So I've got my setup here. Now I use this because, of course, as I start turning, I don't want to be sliding to the outside of it. And I also don't want to be spinning way away from it like this, right? Where I get a bunch of space. What I want to be doing is just hugging it. You can see my hip is just right up against it like this. Okay, now a little bit of space is fine, but I would recommend that we don't be going out here and that we don't get excessive this way. Now, there's two key movements that I want to talk about. The first is having just a little bit of a loading sensation into the right heel like this. So I take my setup here, watch my belt buckle. I'm gonna take my belt buckle and I'm gonna let my belt buckle just kind of drift a little bit on an angle towards my right heel. Okay, see there? Now the opposite of that would be towards my left heel. And if I turned and went towards my left heel, I'd get a lot of space. Now if I let it just kind of go to my right heel and then turn, you can see I just stay right up against that post. Okay, I like a little bit of belt buckle, the pelvis, to just kind of unweight that lead foot a little bit into the right side, and then we start to turn, okay? That's a key move. That's a power move. Henrik Stenson, probably the most notable in doing that, but you see it with Tiger. You see it with Rory. You see it with these long drive men and women, a little bit of a loading sensation into the right heel. Now, the second movement is gonna be rotation, okay? We need the right hip to turn and move up and back that way like that. Okay, my right hip is going up and back that way. And when we do that, we've got to lose a little flexion in my right knee. Okay, so here we go, a little load into the right heel, and then I turn my right hip and it's moving up and back that way. And when I did that, I let my right leg stand up a little bit. And from this view here, you should start to see a little bit of space in between your knees. See that there? Really elongating the right side. That is a key move. So quick little recap here. Belt buckle, a little drift to the right heel, right hip turns, feels like the right leg is standing up. Okay, I feel loaded into my right side. And you'll see here how this left knee, my lead knee, is starting to work across. Okay, it's starting to work across that way. And as you do this, left heel coming up, that's fine. We've got to get the lower body moving. The days of keeping the lower body still and just turning the upper body are in the past. You've got to get the lower body working. You've got to get it drifting towards the right heel just a bit. You got to get the right leg elongating, turning up and back, losing flexion in the knee. Losing flexion in the knee so we get some space. And when we do that, we feel that left knee, that lead knee, starting to work across. We feel that left heel wanting to come up a little bit. And all of that is okay because that's how we need to recruit with the lower body. Give that a try.